This video is going to be specifically about the tools that I found to work really well in distressing barn beams. So I'm going to start from the beginning of the process and work my way to the end. So starting off, clear packing tape to do the miter folds, along with a lot of Collins spring clamps. That gets the 1x10s into a faux box beam, and seems to be the best way. You can't use nails, obviously, because you're going to be hitting it with a planer and whatnot. You don't want any nails in there. So you have to use something without fasteners, and tape and Collins clamps work well. After that, the Festool planer with the undulating head, which is a head you have to buy separately, and it has got a curve to it rather than a straight blade, and that textures the beam. This is an expensive tool to buy. I only use this planer for distressing beams, but you about have to have it unless you want to do a whole lot of manual labor with an atz. The vac in the back here is a CT26 Festool. It's got a Bosch 35 millimeter hose. It's got a long life filter bag in it, which I highly recommend. So that the vac is used with the planer and the Makita wire brush machine. After we texture the beam, the next step is to put in some markings that like an atz would do. So I like this Fisker's X7 hatchet. It's very lightweight, and you're using this so many times it doesn't fatigue your hands too bad. So that's what I've been using, and it works pretty well. To put the cracks in the beam, I found this Dremel tool to work pretty well. It's got just this blade on it. I don't know if you'd even call it a blade. It's more like a grinding disc even. It's pretty thin, but it works really well for making those crack marks. Best tool I found for that. And then I'll use a wide chisel in conjunction with that. If you're doing something like white oak or red oak, this doesn't always work real well, and I've found I've had to use a hammer and a wide chisel. But this is number 2 pine, so the hatchet works really well with it. Basic awl for your powder post beetle holes. And from there, you're not going to be able to see this really well, but this would be the torch that I use. It's just on a stand with a propane tank. I should say not a stand, a rolling cart, but that's what I use to torch the beams, and it's been a really good investment also. The most recent tool that I purchased that really took my beams to the next level was this wire brush machine. So this is pretty expensive. It's about $400, but then you have to buy, it comes with a nylon brush wire wheel, and it's not very aggressive. So I ended up actually purchasing a real wire brush wheel, which was recommended to me by other guys who have this machine, and that works a lot better. So if you're gonna buy this, plan on having to buy the real wire brush machine also. And then I wrap some duct tape around the dust port, and that works really well with the Festool connection that I've got on the end of this Bosch hose. I'll put links in the notes below to all these tools. Whenever you add them all up, it does get pretty expensive whenever you look at the cost of everything, but you really can't replicate genuine barn beams without all these different tools. My philosophy is the beam should look as close to an authentic barn beam as possible. And to do that, you just need certain tools. And these are the ones that I've found work best. So hope this video helps you out. If you've got questions, feel free to comment below. And again, you can follow the links below on Amazon to get these tools.